for groups, this group, they represent the number of valence electrons. They represent the number of valence electron. If any element has one valence electron, that is placed in group 1. If it has two, group 2, like magnesium has 12, that means 2H2. So it has two valence electrons, so it is placed in group 2. But after 12, you remember, if the valence electron is 3, 4, 5, they are placed in 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, like that. Clear? So if the if X element has electronic configuration like 2, 8, 5, this is group 15. Any element, Y, it has 2, 6, that means it is group 16. The periods. Period 1 is the smallest period of the periodic table because it contains only 2 electrons. So period 1 contains 2 elements, and that is hydrogen and helium. Period 2, there are small period, it contains 8 elements. See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 periods are present. So this is small period. Period 3. It also contains 8 elements. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 elements. But from period 4, it has 18 elements, because these two and these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. So it has 18 elements. Period 5 also has 18 elements, but for period 6 and 7, they have 32 elements. 18 plus these. This inner transition, this is inner transition elements. So that means lanthanoids and actinoid series. This part is called lanthanoid series, and this is called actinoid series. So including all these groups or elements, it has 14 more elements. So this has 14 elements. So 18 plus 14 is 32. Clear? So period 1 is the smallest period due to the presence of 2 elements, hydrogen and helium. Period 2 has 8 elements. This is a small period. Period 3 also has 8 elements, again a small period. Period 3 and 4 and 5 has 18 elements, long period. 6 and 7, longest period due to the presence of 32 elements. Now what does this period represent? Period represents the number of valence shell. Period represents number of shells that an element has. Like group represents number of valence electrons. That's why elements are present in group 1, group 2, group 3. And elements which has 2 shells, they are present in second period. Elements which has 3 shells, they are present in the third period, like sodium. If I take an example of sodium. So sodium has 2, 8, 1. This is the configuration of sodium. 11 atomic number. K, L, N shell. So 3 shells are present. So it is in the third period. Like carbon. Carbon is 6. 2, 4. So it has 2 shells, K and L. So it is present in the second period. so it is placed in group 14. It has one valence electron, it is in group 1. So any element, suppose an element A has atomic number Z is, suppose X, A represents mass number, Z is suppose 50. That means, if I write the configuration, it is 2, 8, 5. So it has 5 valence electrons, so it is present in group 15, 3 shells K, L, M, period 3. So this is the position of this element X. Now, if I say element Y has group number 17 and period number 2. If group number is 17, that means it has 7 valence electrons. So I leave some space for here, and if I write the valence electron 7, because it is present in group 17, but it is present in group period 2, that means it has K and L shell, only 2 shells are there. So this must be present in L, K, and K must be 2. The electrons must be fulfilled. It must be 2, it must be 8. The valence electron can be anything apart from 2 or 8. Apart from 8 only. If it is 8, then it is fulfilled. It is present in group 18. If it is not 8, if it is 7, then it is in group 17. If it is 3, it is in group 13. If it is 1, it is in group 1. Like this. So since its group number is 17, that means it has 7 valence electrons, period is 2, that means 2 shells, then 2, 7. Element, suppose M has group number 16, period 3. That means its valence electron is 6. Period 3 means 3 shells including this 6. So K, L, M, 3 shells. So I have to put 2, 8. If suppose an element element C, group number is 2, period 4. Group 2 means it has 2 electrons in its valence shell and 4th period. It is present in the 4th period. That means it has 4 shells. K, L, M, N. 2, 8, 8, 2. This is how we have to determine the position of an element in the periodic table or vice versa. The position will be given. We have to know the atomic number. So the atomic number is 10, 18, 20, Z. For this one it is 16. So I can also predict the atomic number from the position that is given to us, or we can also determine the position from the electronic configuration.